فاشرف بي لاشتغالي بالعلم ولا تبغي به ما عشت يا ذا بدلا ويا له من شرف عظيم.
القاعدة الحادية وثلاثون. The 31st قاعدة, which is أنهم يعتقدون أهل السنة والجماعة believe أن التعامل مع الحوادث, dealing with contemporary issues, المتغيرة, that changes and differs, is أن يكون مبنيا على فهم أدلة الشريعة ومعرفة سنة الله في خلقه. That dealing with current issues of the Muslims that keeps changing and altering, all of it is built upon understanding the textual evidences and also understanding Sunanullahi, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's doings in this world. Sunanullahi fi khalqihi, how Allah does things, that the person has to know history and that they need to also know a bit about the as you would say, the fiqhul of the waqi'. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he says in the Quran, وَإِذَا جَاءَهُمْ أَمْرٌ مِّنَ الْأَمْنِ أَوِ الْخَوْفِ أَذَاعُوا بِهِ وَلَوْ رَدُّوهُ إِلَى الرَّسُولِ وَإِلَى أُولِي الْأَمْرِ مِنْهُمْ لَعَلِمَهُ الَّذِينَ يَسْتَنْبِطُونَهُ مِنْهُمْ ولولا فضل الله عليكم ورحمته لاتبعتم الشيطان إلا قليلا. وقال تعالى ذلك بأن الله لم يكن مغيرا نعمة أنعمها على قوم حتى يغيروا ما بأنفسهم وأن الله سميع عليم. Allah also says, أَوَلَمَّا أَصَابَتْكُمْ مُصِيبَةٌ قَدْ أَصَبْتُمْ مِثْلَيْهَا قُلْتُمْ أَنَّا هَذَا قُلْ هُوَ مِنْ عِنْدِ أَنفُسِكُمْ إِنَّ اللَّهَ عَلَى كُلِّ شَيْءٍ قَدِيرٌ. Allah also says, وَيَا قَوْمِ لَا يَجْرِمَنَّكُمْ شِقَاقِي أَنْ يُصِيبَكُمْ مِثْلُ مَا أَصَابَ قَوْمَ نُوحٍ أَوْ قَوْمَ هُودٍ أَوْ قَوْمَ صَالِحٍ وَمَا قَوْمُ لُوطٍ مِّنْكُمْ بِبَعِيدٍ. Allah also says, لَيْسَ بِأَمَانِيِّكُمْ وَلَا أَمَانِيِّ أَهْلِ الْكِتَابِ مَنْ يَعْمَلْ سُوءًا يُجْزَ بِهِ وَلَا يَجِدْ لَهُ مِنْ دُونِ اللَّهِ وَلِيًّا وَلَا نَصِيرًا. Allah also says, وَكَذَلِكَ جَعَلْنَا لِكُلِّ نَبِيٍ عَدُوًا شَيَاطِينَ الْإِنسِ وَالْجِنِّ يُوحِي بَعْضُهُمْ إِلَى بَعْضٍ زُخْرُفَ الْقَوْلِ غُرُورًا وَلَوْ شَاءَ رَبُّكَ مَا فَعَلُوهُ فَذَرْهُمْ وَمَا يَفْتَرُونَ. Allah says subhanahu wa ta'ala, وَكَذَلِكَ جَعَلْنَا فِي كُلِّ قَرْيَةٍ أَكَابِرَ مُجْرِمِيهَا لِيَمْكُرُوا فِيهَا وَمَا يَمْكُرُونَ إِلَّا بِأَنفُسِهِمْ وَمَا يَشْعُرُونَ. وقال تعالى, Allah also says, وَكَذَلِكَ نُوَلِّي بَعْضَ الظَّالِمِينَ بَعْضًا بِمَا كَانُوا يَكْسِبُونَ. Allah also says, إِنَّ الَّذِينَ اتَّخَذُوا الْعِجْلَ سَيَنَالُهُمْ غَضَبٌ مِّنْ رَبِّهِمْ وَذِلَّةٌ فِي الْحَيَاةِ الدُّنْيَا وَكَذَلِكَ نَجْزِي الْمُفْتَرِينَ. Allah also says subhanahu wa ta'ala, يا أيها الذين آمنوا عليكم أنفسكم لا يضركم من ضل إذا اهتديتم إلى الله مرجعكم جميعا فينبئكم بما كنتم تعملون. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he says, this qa'ida, first of all, Ahlul Sunnah wal Jama'ah, they know that they are going through current situations that the Muslims are going through. And these are hawadith which are mutaghayyira, they change as time goes on. But they all know that the way that they should deal with these issues is by taking it back to the textual evidence. And also knowing how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala does things. Sunanullah, Allah's way of doing things. Allah told us in the Quran, ذَلِكَ بِأَنَّ اللَّهَ لَمْ يَكُمْ مُغَيِّرًا نِعْمَةً أَنْعَمَهَا عَلَىٰ قَوْمٍ حَتَّى يُغَيِّرُ مَا بِأَنفُسِهِمْ. Allah does not change a situation of a people and the problems that they are in unless they change their own actions. So the changing of a situation is connected to the changing of the actions. Simple. Once your action changes, your situation changes. And then this is called sunanullah fi khalqi. Allah's way of how He deals with His creation. Allah says in the Quran, وَكَذَلِكَ نُوَلِّي بَعْضَ الظَّالِمِينَ بَعْضًا بِمَا كَانُوا يَفْسُقُونَ. We find that Allah is saying that the transgressive leader is a result of the bad doings of the people. وَكَذَلِكَ نُوَلِّي بَعْضَ الظَّالِمِينَ بَعْضًا. We make oppressive leaders over the transgressors. You're a dhalim, you're a fasiq yourself. You're transgressing on your wife. You're transgressing on your children. You're transgressing on your neighbors. You're transgressing on your neighborhood. And of course Allah is going to place over you a transgressive leader who has no mercy towards you. هذا سنن الله في خلقه. The ulama of Al-Sunnah know that. So that's why they don't direct their efforts towards the leader. Because the leader is a result. There's something that's bringing him about. Al-Sunnah wal-Jama'ah, they don't go towards the leader then. They focus on the people. Because if the people change, the leader will change. Are you with me? The leader will change. They also know Ahlul Sunnah wal Jama'ah, in dealing with these issues, they need to take it back to the ulama. That you don't take these issues that involve the safety and the security of the people, they don't take it to the jahl and the amatul nas. And even within the ulama, there are people who are khawas. Not every alim needs to be speaking about this issue as well. There are khawas who specialize in these issues. Diqqatun nadhar, abqariyya. They've combined between fahmu adilati sharia, and they also very well known sunanullahi fi khalqi. لذلك, if you look at, for example, Sheikh Muhammad Nasiruddin al-Albani, when, for example, the issue that was happening in Algeria and how it took place, Sheikh Nasir said something very powerful. He said that the Muslims, because at that time, what happened is exactly what took place in Egypt. It was a group of Muslims, who were fighting with the liberals, okay, over leadership in Algeria. And the students of Sheikh Albani, rahimahullah, said, "Ya Sheikh, it looks like the Islamists, the Muslims are going to win. The Islamiyun are going to get the upper hand and they're going to be elected by the people because it was through election that they were choosing. It looks like it, man." Sheikh Nasir said they're not going to get it. Guess what happened? They did get elected. So the students came to Sheikh Nasir and said, "Sheikh, look, we told you, you got it wrong, Sheikh Muhammad Nasir. You got it wrong. Look, they got chosen." Sheikh Nasir said, "Choosing doesn't mean you just come into the seat. Watch, they're not going to last for a year." And it was as he said. Are you with me, brothers? They got taken down, and Sheikh Nasir said, when they get taken down, when this changes, it's going to bring a bad name for Muslims and Islam. And that's exactly what happened. Are you with me, brothers? This is the scholars. وَلِذَلِكَ الْعُلَمَاء. Look what they know. They know the fitna before it even comes. They're looking at the eyes, like, Allah, people, this is a fitna. It's going to come. It's going to destroy you guys. Be careful. The jahala, the amatul nas, the general folks, us, we only realize it was a fitna after it's gone. We're like, you know what, subhanallah, all that time that we would do, it was a fitna. We don't realize it even when we're in it. They know it before it even comes. Because there's these telltale signs, there's signs that they're looking at that are telling them this fitna is going to come. But the jahala, the amatul nas, they only realize it's a fitna once it's long gone. They say, you know what, that was a trial and tribulation, subhanAllah. It was fitna. It wasn't as we thought. So that's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He says, وَإِذَا جَاءَهُمْ أَمْرٌ مِنَ الْأَمْنِ أَوِ الْخَوْفِ أَذَاعُوا بِهِ وَلَوْ رَدُّوهُ إِلَى الرَّسُولِ وَإِلَىٰ أُولِي الْأَمْرِ مِنْهُمْ لَعَلِمَهُ الَّذِينَ يَسْتَنْبِطُونَهُ مِنْهُمْ. If only they brought these matters back to who? وَلَوْ رَدُّوهُ إِلَىٰ الرَّسُولِ. They brought it back to Allah. وَلَوْ رَدُّوهُ إِلَىٰ الرَّسُولِ. They brought it back to Allah and His Messenger. وَإِلَىٰ أُولِي الْأَمْرِ مِنْهُمْ. And those who have authority over them, meaning the ulama, the people of knowledge. If they were to bring it back to them, those scholars would have done justice to the matter. They would have solved the problem. Allah tells the Prophet ﷺ that when things happen to him, that this happened to him because this is the sunnah of Allah. Allah says, أَوَلَمَّا أَصَابَتْكُمْ مُصِيبَةٌ قَدْ أَصَبْتُمْ مِثْلَيْهَا قُلْتُمْ أَنَّا هَذَا قُلْ هُوَ مِنْ عِنْدِ أَنفُسِكُمْ إِنَّ اللَّهَ بِكُلِّ شَيْءٍ قَدِيرٌ أَمَا إِنَّ اللَّهَ عَلَى كُلِّ شَيْءٍ قَدِيرٌ. أَوَلَمَّا أَصَابَتْكُمْ مُصِيبَةٌ. When the calamity befell you, قُلْتُمْ أَنَّ هَذَا. You said to yourselves, where did this come from? قُلْ هُوَ مِنْ عِنْدِ أَنفُسِكُمْ. This came from you guys. The reason why you guys have this calamity fallen onto you is because of what your hands have put forward. And don't blame Allah. Don't look at Allah and say, oh Allah, why did you put me through this? Why have Allah has made me suffer? It's your own doings. قُلْ هُوَ مِنْ عِنْدِ أَنفُسِكُمْ إِنَّ اللَّهَ عَلَى كُلِّ شَيْءٍ قَدِيرٌ. Allah is able to do everything. I mean, Allah can take you out of the calamity. Allah sunan fi khalqihi, in which He deals with His creation. So the people of ilm, they combine between those two. When dealing with problems, أهل السنة والجماعة deal with it what? مَبْنِيًا عَلَى فَهْمِ أَدِلَّةِ الشَّرِيعَةِ وَمَعْرِفَةِ سُنَنِ اللَّهِ فِي خَلْقِهِ. وَلِذَلِكَ أَهْلُ الْبِدَعِ, all they tell you is that this country is going to do this. All day they will tell you political strategies and different rules and regulations and etc. But they won't tell you adilla from the kitab and the sunnah. They won't tell you qala Allah and qala Rasul. Never find that in their kalam. They'll make it come across to you that they are aware of the waqi'. Maybe they do know the waqi', but that doesn't allow them and give them the green light and give them the permission in any way, form or shape for them to come out and to speak about this current problem. It doesn't give them the rights. They only have one side of the issue, which is what? Maybe they know the ma'rifatu sunan illahi fi khalqi, but do they know the adillat al-shari'ah in this matter? For example, if somebody comes up to you and says to you, the scholars don't know our situation, they don't know our issue. Maybe you're right in this issue. Maybe they don't know it. Nah, maybe, probably, there might be a chance. But they know the evidence. They know the ahkam. It makes more sense for you to take it to them. And to put this situation to them clearly then. If you know the reality of the issue, then take it to them. Put it to them. Say, this is the situation of our issue. This is what's happening. We need to explain it to you properly. And they are now going to give you the ruling of Allah in this issue. Because they have the deen. And this is something that you can't attain over internet, brothers. Wallahi, you can't. Knowing the current situation and what's happening, that's easy. Anyone can do that. Just follow the news for a week. You'll find out what's happening. Sah? But knowing the deen and the istinbatat al-ahkam, how to extract the deen from the ayat and the kitab and the sunnah, and how to place it in this particular situation correctly, this is specific for the people of knowledge. And since they have something that's the most important thing, if you know the situation better than the scholar, then take it to him. Allow him to see the issue clearly so he can give a good and a correct ruling in this issue. It doesn't justify. Just because you believe that they don't know your situation, it doesn't give you the right in any way, form or shape to say, so I've got the situation on and the perception of the reality, so I'm going to give the fatwa of this issue. That is incorrect. That does not make sense. It's incorrect. Al-Qa'idatu al-Thaniya wa thalathun. The 32nd principle. Al-Qa'idatu al-Thaniya wa thalathun. And this Qa'ida is wujubu tahdhir al-Ummah min a'immat al-Bid'ah. That it's obligatory to warn the Muslims, the Ummah, to warn the Ummah from a'immatul bid'ah, the leaders of innovation, to warn them against innovators and the people who are propagating that innovation, that you warn them against them. Allah says in the Quran, وَمِمَّنْ خَلَقْنَا أُمَّةٌ يَهْدُونَ بِالْحَقِّ وَبِهِ يَعْدِلُونَ. Allah also says, لَوْلَا يَنْهَاهُمُ الرَّبَّانِيُّونَ وَالْأَحْبَارُ عَنْ قَوْلِهِمُ الْإِثْمَ وَأَكْلِهِمُ السُّحْتَ لَبِئْسَ مَا كَانُوا يَصْنَعُونَ. Allah also says, قالوا يا صالح قد كنت فينا مرجوا قبل هذا أتنهانا أن نعبد ما يعبد آباؤنا وإننا لفي شك مما تدعونا إليه مريب. Allah also says, كانوا لا يتناهون عن منكر فعلوه لبئس ما كانوا يفعلون. Allah also says, يا أيها الذين آمنوا إن كثيرا من الأحبار والرهبان ليأكلون أموال الناس بالباطل ويصدون عن سبيل الله والذين يكنزون الذهب والفضة ولا ينفقونها في سبيل الله فبشرهم بعذاب أليم. This qaida speaks about warning against the people who propagate innovation and the leaders of innovation. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He told us, لَوْلَا يَنْهَاهُمُ الرَّبَّانِيُونَ وَالْأَحْبَارُ عَنْ قَوْلِهِمُ الْإِثْمَ وَأَكْلِهِمُ السُّحْتَ لَبِئْسَ مَا كَانُوا يَصْنَعُونَ. If they did not prohibit the rabbis and the monks from their speeches, their evil speeches, and their eating of haram, if they weren't prevented from it, لَبِئْسَ مَا كَانُوا يَصْنَعُونَ, what an evil thing that they would have done. In other words, if they didn't come out and they didn't speak against the innovations that were added to their religion, the things that were done about their deen, Allah says, what an evil thing they would have done. So Allah referred to their leaving off calling to the good and prohibiting the evil. Allah referred to it as an action. So this is where the scholars took from, that not doing something itself is an action. Not doing something itself is an action. Also Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He said, كَانُوا لَا يَتَنَاهَوْنَ عَن مُنْكَرٍ فَعَلُوهُ لَبِئْسَ مَا كَانُوا يَفْعَلُونَ. Allah says, they never used to prevent each other from evil. What an evil thing they did. So they didn't used to prevent each other from evil. Rather, at the beginning of that verse, Allah says, لُعِنَ الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا مِنْ بَنِي إِسْرَائِيلَ عَلَى لِسَانِ دَاوُودَ وَعِيسَى بْنِ مَرْيَمَ ذَلِكَ بِمَا عَصَوْا وَكَانُوا يَعْتَدُونَ. صح؟ كَانُوا لَا يَتَنَاهَوْنَ عَن مُنْكَرٍ فَعَلُوهُ لَبِئْسَ مَا كَانُوا يَفْعَلُونَ. They were cursed on the tongue of Dawood and Isa ibn Maryam. They cursed those people. Who did they curse? Those who كانوا لا يتناهون عن منكر فعلوا. They would see somebody do evil and they wouldn't stop them from it. They are cursed on the tongue of Dawood and Isa ibn Maryam. So is bid'ah munkar? Huh? So if we don't stop it, we will be cursed on whose tongue? Dawood and Isa ibn Maryam. Their curse will be upon us because we saw evil take place on our time and we didn't come and we didn't warn against it. Shaykh al-Islam ibn Taymiyyah said something very, very powerful. He said, وَمِثْلُ أَئِمَّةِ الْبِدَعِ مِنْ أَهْلِ الْمَقَالَاتِ الْمُخَالِفَةِ لِلْكِتَابِ وَالسُّنَّةِ أَوْ الْعِبَادَاتِ الْمُخَالِفَةِ لِلْكِتَابِ وَالسُّنَّةِ فَإِنَّ بَيَانَ حَالِهِمْ وَتَحْذِيرِ الْأُمَّةِ مِنْهُمْ وَاجِبٌ بِاتِّفَاقِ الْمُسْلِمِينَ. Ibn Taymiyyah says, the likes of this is the leaders of innovation, a'immatul bid'ah, the heads of and the figureheads of innovation, those who propagate innovation, who have statements that are in opposition to the kitab and the sunnah, or they have ibadat, worships, that are in opposition to the kitab and the sunnah, فَإِنَّ بَيَانَ حَالِهِمْ, clarifying those people's situation, وَتَحْذِيرِ الْأُمَّةِ مِنْهُمْ, and warning the people from them is wajib. بِاتِّفَاقِ الْمُسْلِمِينَ, it's obligatory by consent of the Muslims. Are we together, brothers? أَئِمَّةُ الْبِدْعَ, the leaders of innovation, people whose statements are in opposition to the kitab and the sunnah, they have ibadat which are in opposition to the kitab and the sunnah, فَإِنَّ بَيَانَ حَالِهِمْ clarifying those people's situation to the people, exposing them, is وَتَحَذِيرُ الْأُمَّةِ مِنْهُمْ and warning the Muslims from them is wajib. بِاتِّفَاقِ الْمُسْلِمِينَ there's no khilaf about this. This matter is consensus, there's no khilaf. حَتَّى قِيلَ لِأَحْمَدِ بْنَ حَنْبَلَ until it was said to Imam Ahmad, الرَّجُلُ يَصُومُ a man fasts, وَيُصَلِّ and he prays, وَيَعْتَكِفُ and he does i'tikaf. أَحَبُّ إِلَيْكَ is he more beloved to you? أَوْ يَتَكَلَّمُ فِي أَهْلِ الْبِدَعِ or for him to speak about the innovators. Which one is more beloved to you? فَقَالَ Imam Ahmad said, إِذَا صَامَ وَصَلَّى if this person prays and he fasts, وَعْتَكَفَ and he does i'tikaf in the masjid, فَإِنَّمَا هُوَ لِنَفْسِهِ he's doing this for himself. وَإِذَا تَكَلَّمَ but when he speaks, فِي أَهْلِ الْبِدَعِ he speaks about the people of innovation, فَإِنَّمَا هُوَ لِلْمُسْلِمِينَ this is, he's doing it for the Muslims. هذا أفضل, that's greater and better. So which one is better to Ahmad ibn Hanbal? التحذير من أهل البدع, warning against the innovators. But remember, it's warning against an innovator, not warning against your Muslim brother who holds the same aqidah as you, just because he didn't, just because you have personal issues against him. This is not what it is. Ah, the matter is that you're warning against a mubtada, a person of innovation. Then this for sure is better than a fasting and the praying. Look what Shaykh Al-Islam Taymiyyah carried on saying. فَبَيَّنَا he's now going to explain to us what Ahmad ibn Hanbal meant. He said, فَبَيَّنَا he clarified to us, يعني Imam Ahmad, أَنَّ نَفْعَ هَذَا عَامٌ لِلْمُسْلِمِينَ that the benefits of warning against the innovator, the benefits that are in it are greater لِلْمُسْلِمِينَ for the Muslims فِي دِينِهِمْ in the terms of their religion. Warning against the innovators, criticizing them, exposing them to the people is greater for the Muslims in their religion. This is called, as we said yesterday, this is called masalih and benefits which are what? Mutaaddiya. Benefits that are not exclusive to you, it encompasses others. It's better. This is better, la shak. It is better than the masalih which are what? Masalih which are qasira. And we spoke about this yesterday. Ibn Taymiyyah says, فَبَيِّنْ أَنَّفْعَ هَذَا عَامٌ لِلْمُسْلِمِينَ فِي دِينِهِمْ مِنْ جِنْسِ الْجِهَادِ فِي سَبِيلَ اللَّهِ rather, warning against innovators is a jihad fi sabila. You're a mujahid. You're doing jihad by fighting against the innovators. Why? إِذْ تَطْخِيرُ سَبِيلِ اللَّهِ وَدِينِهِ because you're purifying Allah's religion. Ya ikhwa, pay attention to this. Warning against the innovators is cleaning the religion. It's تَطْخِيرُ سَبِيلِ اللَّهِ you're cleaning Allah's path. وَدِينِهِ his religion. وَمَنَاهِجِهِ وَشِرْعَتِهِ وَدَفْعُ بَغْيِ هَؤُلَاءِ وَعُدْوَانِهِمْ and you're also repelling the oppression and the transgression of these individuals. عَلَى ذَلِكَ upon the religion. And it is wajibun عَلَى الْكِفَايَةِ it is obligatory, it's a communal obligation. It's not obligatory on everybody. You can't do it? Well, I can. Don't speak against me. Why are you going to speak against me if I'm doing it? Are you, you're unable to take this obligation on you. You feel your iman is not that strong. The one who stood up for him, make dua for him. Say, Allahumma qawwihi. Oh Allah, strengthen him. I can't do this. He's done something I can't do. He says, this is wajibun ala al-kifayati bi-ittifaq al-muslimin. Again, Ibn Taymiyyah keeps bringing ittifaq. This is not a difference of opinion. The ittifaq here is what? Some people say, Akhi, fulan is better than you. Why is he better than you? He's in the masjid. He's fasting. He's praying. He's doing his ibadat. Look at him, Allahu Akbar. Here you are. All the warning against al-bidah. Which was better? According to Imam Ahmad, this is better. وَلَوْلَا Ibn Taymiyyah said them, pay attention. وَلَوْلَا مَنْ يُقِيمُهُ اللَّهِ if these people who stood up to defend the religion, to expose and to refute the innovators, if it wasn't for those people, okay, لِدَفْعِ ضَرَرِ هَؤُلَاءِ لَفَسَدَ الدِّينُ the religion would have been corrupt. If it wasn't for these people who stood up to repel the harm of these individuals, who are trying to tamper with the religion, who are trying to change the religion of Allah. If it wasn't for those people, mashallah, who stood up, لَفَسَدَ الدِّينُ our religion would have been corrupt. إِذَا اسْتَوْلَوْ لَمْ يُفْسِدُ الْقُلُوبِ فَإِنَّ هَؤُلَاءِ وَإِنَّ شَيْخُ الْإِسْلَامِ تَيْمِ said, وَكَانَ فَسَادُ أَعْظَمْ مِنْ فِسَادِ اسْتِلَاءِ الْعَدُوِ مِنْ أَهْلِ الْحَرْبِ rather, the harm that these innovators and these corrupt individuals will bring about is greater than that which the enemies and the disbelievers will bring about. Wow. The harm that these people bring is greater. وَكَانَ فَسَادُهُ his fasad, his corruption. أَعْظَمْ is greater than فَسَادِ اسْتِلَاءِ الْعَدُوِ than the disbelievers overtaking the Muslim land. Ya ikhwah, are we pondering here? Hada kalam Ibn Taymiyyah rahimahullah. That disbelievers coming into the Muslim land, taking over the Muslim land. Ibn Taymiyyah saying, this is worse. The innovator is worse. How? Min ahl al-harb. فَإِنَّ هَؤُلَاءِ لَسْتَوْلَوْا. Because this disbeliever, when he comes and he takes over the Muslim land, لَمْ يُفْسِدُ الْقُلُوبِ. They don't corrupt the hearts. The disbeliever will come, take over the land, but he won't get to the people's hearts. وَمَا فِيهَا مِنَ الدِّينِ. And they won't get to the heart. And they won't get to those people's religion. They won't. إِلَّا تَبْعًا. Maybe after they take over the land, maybe that might be the second thing. But they won't directly be able to. Whereas what? أَمَّا أَوْلَائِكَ. As for the mubtadi'ah, the innovators and the corrupt ones. فَهُمْ يُفْسِدُونَ الْقُلُوبَ ابْتِدَاءً. They corrupt the heart straight away. Because why? You don't know he's with you. He's praying with you. He's your friend. You can't. There's no difference and distinguishing between the two of you. You're Muslims together. He's praying with you. The disbelief, when he takes over your land, you already know there's a war between you and him. He's taken my land. He's coming to my land. He's oppressing me. People, there's already a line drawn. So for him to get to you is close to impossible. It's very hard. Sahih, ya ikhwah? Are you with me? ولذلك, I mentioned yesterday, Shaykh al-Islam Taymiyyah mentioned in Majmu'ul Fatawa that Ibn Taymiyyah quoted this from who? Ibn Taymiyyah quoted this from Ibn Salah. Ibn Salah said, Sayfuddin al-Amidi. Sayfuddin al-Amidi was a man who controlled and he had his own madrasa. Sayfuddin al-Amidi had a madrasa of his. He had a madrasa where he used to teach and he was an innovator. Sayfuddin al-Amidi was an innovator who basically, upon the belief of the Ahlul Kalam, Ibn Salah said, for Allah to take back the land of Uqa, which was a land Muslims lost from the disbelievers. The disbelievers took over the land from the Muslims. For the Muslims to regain that land, to gain that land again, for them to gain that again, wouldn't be as good as if they were to take the madrasa off Sayfuddin al-Amidi. For Sayfuddin al-Amidi to lose that madrasa and the leadership of the madrasa is far greater than the Muslims to regain Uqa. You see the seriousness of how it was to the ulama, the bid'ah. So this is the reality of it. So since those statements are very strong, the person like him you are referring to as a mubtadi' is not easy. Ya ikhwah, is not a light issue. As Imam Ahmad himself said, he said, إِخْرَاجُ النَّاسِ عَنِ السُّنَّةِ شَدِيدًا. Taking the people out of the sunnah is a very severe issue. It's not a light matter. To say fulan is a mubtadi' ya akhi, هذا يحتاج إلى دقة النظر. That requires a lot of looking. It requires a lot of observation. It requires understanding and it requires knowledge. It requires knowledge. It requires knowledge. Imam Ibn al-Qayyim said a very powerful statement. Shaykh Abdullah ibn Salih al-Ubaylan brings it. But I'm going to read it on you guys, inshallah. He said this in his kitab, As-Sawa'iq al-Mursala. Ibn Taymiyyah said, Allah, 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 meaning by Allah, Muslims. Al-thiqqatu bil-ashkhasi al-dalalu. Completely entrusting a person is misguidance. This personality that you find Muslims all about, Fulan, Shaykh this personality that people draw, he can't get it wrong, impossible. How can he be? This idolizing people like this. الثِّقَّةُ بِالْأَشْخَاصِ الضَّلَالُ وَالرُّكُونُ إِلَى الْآرَاءِ ابْتِدَاعٌ. And then what? Leaning towards opinions is innovation. And you find that today. That people, they've taken a person so much high than the truth itself. That this person, if somebody comes and says, Ya akhi, akhta'a fulan. Hatta just mujarrad khata. Fulan got it wrong. He just got this wrong. Never ever. How could Fulan get it wrong? Are you with me? How could what? This is called taqdeesu al-ashkhas. This is called what? It's called taqdeesu al-ashkhas. That you're making this person a divine law. Are you with me? Everybody, Imam Malik said a statement which is general and generic. What did he say? And Imam Malik said, كل يؤخذ من قوله ويرد. Everybody's statement is either accepted or rejected. إلا صاحب هذا القبر. Except the Prophet. Everybody else is راد ومردود. Everybody's speech is between الأخذ والرد. Except his rejection. Is it right? Yeah, we take it. No, it's wrong today. He got it wrong today. Okay, sorry. Lakin, yes. Everybody who gets it wrong is dealt with differently. Some alim gets it wrong. He will say he's wrong. أخطأ. And that does not entail, nor does it give anybody the right, just because a mistake occurred from him, إهدار مكانته, to put his status down, and to belittle him and ridicule him. Because as we said before, everybody will do a mistake. As the poet said, وَمَنْ ذَا الَّذِي تُرْضَى سَجَايَاهُ كُلُّهَا كَفَى الْمَرْءِ نُبْلًا أَنْ تُعَدَّ مَعَيْبُ. Who is the person that he will never do a mistake and never get anything wrong? But what is honorable is, this person has been given da'wah for 20 years, 30 years, 40 years, and you've only got 4 mistakes on him, 5 mistakes. It's honorable, mashallah. Ajeeb. Allahu Akbar. I mean, for 30 years, I thought he would have done more mistakes, right? So everybody is going to do mistakes. Just because you said, oh, fulan, there's mulahadat on him, or there is akhtat that we found in him. Ya akhi, you've just shown me he's a human being. You see? He's a human being. But not every mistake is acceptable though. Some mistakes will take you out of the fold of Ahlul Sunnah wal Jama'ah. Some mistakes. So when people say to Akhi, what he did, yeah, it's a mistake. Ya Akhi, not every mistake is the same. Are you with me? Not every mistake is the same. Are you with me, brothers? So that has to be understood. Al-Qa'idatu thalatha wa thalathun. Al-Thalithatu wa thalathun. Al-Qa'idatu thalithatu wa thalathun. The 33rd qa'ida, and that is Ahlul Sunnah wal Jama'ah believe anna Ahlul Bid'ah aqsam. Another belief from Ahlul Sunnah. Ahlul Sunnah wal Jama'ah believe that the people of innovations are of different levels. So now we just took the warn against innovators, and we also took the statement of Ibn Taymiyyah, right? Are you there, brothers? Are we all there together, brothers? Are we there? Also, we took the statement of Shaykh al-Islam ibn Taymiyyah regarding Ibn Salah, what he said about Sayfuddin al-Amidi. Rather, what's actually shocking is that Sayfuddin al-Amidi's bid'ah is not as big as other people's bid'ah that were before him, like Fakhruddin al-Razi, Abubakr ibn Fawraq. It wasn't even that big. Are you there? The point is here that some people today who call themselves Salafis, Ahlul Sunnah, the way that they deal with the Mubtadi'ah is of one level. The Jahmi and the Salafi brother of theirs that done a mistake is the same in the way they deal with them. Rather, they may even deal harsher with their Salafi brother, their Ahlul Sunnah brother. Sah? And this is another incorrect way of seeing things. That not every Mubtadi' is of one level. Are you with me, brothers? They're not all the same. They're not all one level. And they're not, the way you deal with them is not the same. Ahlul Sunnah believe that. And the people who fall into bid'ah are not all the same.